the title is steel-based applications in earthquake prone areas, and it's a project of 18 months that started in July 2014 and that will end at the end of December 2015, so very soon. In this project, there are 16 members, partners, coming from 7 different countries: Italy, Greece, Belgium, Finland, France, Dutch, Germany, and Romania. And the coordinator of the project is the University of Pisa in Italy. So this simulation project was born on the need to develop practical tools and documents for engineers, standardization bodies, and construction companies. The objective was to exploit at the best the results obtained in 3 successfully concluded LFCF projects: steel earthquake, precast steel, and obvious projects. So the main topics of these 3 projects are: for the steel earthquake, it was about the seismic rehabilitation of existing masonry and reinforced concrete buildings by means of steel-based solutions, also including new solutions for dissipative systems. Precast steel project was about to define suitable pre-designed solutions of steel and steel concrete industrial and commercial buildings. So this is very simple. They are provided very simple tools, and we can design commercial or industrial buildings very simply. So Opus has the objective to optimize steel performance for structural design, ductile design. But inside steel hubs were organized as during 1 year. We have worked on different subjects, providing technical documents, normative environmental indications, development of numerical examples, and so on. And during this last 6 months, we are organizing the dissemination activities through workshops, conferences, seminars, and courses. The work has been organized into 6 different work packages. So the main one has the objective to run technical sheets and logic and graphics. So you can see here the list. For example, we have some documents for the seismic design. We have 5 types of industrial and commercial buildings. And for each type, you will have very soon a technical sheet and working example. The same for seismic rehabilitation. We have 8 different subjects, and for each subject, we have technical sheets and working examples. They are not yet finished, but as soon as we will have, I will send you by email. So our second objective was to arrange pre-normative background documents. We will have 2 background documents for the harmonization of design and production standards, and also some contributions and pre-normative documents for Eurocodes and the new generation of Eurocodes. We have another objective that was the translation of documents and the arrangement of a website for dissemination. The Steelhot's website is available in the ECCS, inside the ECCS website, so you can go inside the ECCS page, choose projects, go to research from Poland Steel, and you can choose the Steelhot's project. It is divided in several tabs. You have the mission that is explained and reminded. Also, this website is available in 6 languages: English, French, Greek, German, Romanian, and Italian. We have other tabs that where you can download all the documents freely for the seismic design, for the seismic grab, the pre-normative documents. We have a list of links, and we have the list of all our events, and the list of the partners of the project. The 4th step that we had was to translate precast steel dynamic web pages users manual into different languages. In fact, in precast steel projects, they have developed a very simple software. It will be shown later. translations. This tool will be translated into six languages: the French, German, Greek, Italian, and Romanian. And finally, we have the organization of workshops and dissemination activities. We have 10 workshops in Europe, 5 conferences in the Emilia-Romagna area in Italy, and 2 courses at the center in Italy also. We are now about half of our leaders here in Madrid. For the conferences in Italy, you have a lot of people who are participating, and all the same program was given to all the conferences in 5 cities. For the workshops, 8 workshops are organized in the various countries, and ECCS is organizing 3 additional workshops here in Madrid, in Spain, in Cuernavaca, Romania, and soon in Lima, Portugal, in order to disseminate outside our partner countries. So the main objective of the workshop of today is to explore material shortages and structural solutions while dealing with seismic loads, and also focusing on industrial and commercial buildings. Two training courses are organized by the center in Italy. One was made with this program. It's all in Italian, so just for Italian people. The advantage of this training course is that it includes exercise and applications. And we have received our brochure with all the documents that you can download soon, very soon in our website, that I will send you an email. And you have also the list of all the events. So I will just give now a very slight overview of what was done in each project that we are disseminating. The plan will be given by our two experts. So for Stiklerhof, the objective was to identify and propose steel solutions for seismic retrofit of existing buildings using steel solutions, in order to guarantee adequate seismic safety levels and reduce eventual costs of intervention. They had a methodology which was first analysis of structural damages affecting single elements, main resisting structures, overall structures. They have chosen the performance-based earthquake engineering approach based on Fermat and Newton aid. Then two decisional tools have been prepared in order to rapidly and extensively analyze several existing retrofitting techniques. In fact, they have analyzed 100 techniques for vertical elements, horizontal elements, and also for foundations. They used two benchmark buildings, a reinforced concrete building and a masonry building, and by doing numerical simulations, each selected technical solution was studied. Also, seismic performance was assessed, and vulnerabilities were identified. So, also solutions for existing foundations were studied, and an economic comparison between different techniques was done, was provided by the project. In this project, also three main experimental tests, two main subjects were done. So the first one was testing steel shear walls. Then they also tested working with restraint and braces, concentric braces configurations. And another dissipative system was also tested experimentally. So all the results will be shown after in the presentation of the transition. All the technical tools that have been developed and chosen in this project were applied to real cases and the other. For precasting, this project focused on the definition of prefabricated steel and steel concrete composite solutions for single story in this term and low-rise homes and buildings. So the structural solutions were conceived in order to represent an effective alternative to rent-first complete solutions, to fix structural efficiency and cost control, easy and rapid to use, and a user-friendly software and web application were designed and provided. Some statistical and market analysis was performed at the beginning of the project. And for the industrial buildings, several types of solutions have been chosen, for example, the outdoor profiles or the platform profiles, and so on. And for the commercial buildings, they were conceived in a simple system where elements can be designed separately, with the gravity structure on one side and the seismic resistance structure on the other side. Different bracing systems were considered, eccentric, braced bracing, concentric bracing, walls and walls, completely additional dissipative systems. So, general guidelines were provided and it will be shown later on the main presentation of this project. And this is the software that is fully available online. So for the office project, very slightly of this project, the objective was to assess the influence of modular properties scattering on final structural performance of steel and steel concrete structures.